I'm here with my main man, Jeremy Bunnell, and we got a heck of a show today. We're going to be looking at the best largemouth bass baits during the wintertime. But boy, Jeremy and I did not pick any day. We picked a day that's got tremendous wind. 20 to 30 mile per hour sustained, gust going over 50. We've seen trees falling over right in front of us. It's amazing. This is a little tiny guy. We're going to catch a bigger. And no surprise, first one falls me. The umbrella ring. In the wintertime for largemouth basses, history tells me, is the blade bait. Blade bait is just really hard to beat anytime you got water temperatures in the low 40s down to where it freezes. Oh, man. Best baits in the winter. You see the Ned Rig, Alabama rig, and you're not going to be surprised what I'm hooking this pole up with. It's a blade bait. Red hook. We're just casting. Every time I put my perspective, look at my live scope, I see the fish kind of out in the middle of this channel. But they definitely move a lot. People think fish don't move in winter. They don't know what the heck they're talking about. I do think our boat is influencing them some, though. Look out. Basically a double. Bunnell's hooked up. Oh, that's not a bad fish either, Jeremy. Oh my goodness, no. That's a good old fish on that Ned Rig. Jeremy, can you tell me, everybody knows how I work a blade, but how do you work a Ned Rig?
So that varies on the time of year or what we're doing, but today it's super cold. I'm trying to keep this thing on the bottom. Basically just twitching that, keeping it on the bottom, and slow.
Everything Jeremy and I are using today tackle-wise is down below with even links to most of it. Number two should probably be number three, but I just like the Alabama rig more than the Ned rig. I love the Alabama rig. I've caught doubles, I've caught triples the Alabama rig, and it does tend to catch bigger fish. Got nails again. Color for your swim baits, but also the speed of your retrieve. Can't emphasize how important the speed of the retrieve is. They're going to want it one way or another, it seems, and it can be 180 degrees different from one day to the next. Today, it is slow rolling. I mean, that thing is on the bottom. I'm barely moving my handle, but that seems to be the ticket today. Number three, but really should be number two, is the Ned Rig. I say it should be number two because it definitely catches more fish. Generally speaking, I think that the Ned Rig is a more reliable choice during the winter. Hey, that's it for now! Sitting there behind me. Oh, that's a Bunnell's best fish. What'd you catch that sucker on?
The old Nedley.
Uh-huh, the old Nedley. Ned, there you go.
Deadly Ned.
Deadly. Might be jackpot hook there. I know most people think I'm just absolutely nuts and insane to be fishing in these conditions, but good news is Jeremy's insane, just like me. But big question I get all the time for people who don't know, how in the world do you stay warm? Hey, it's just, you pay for the equipment. I got this Ice Striker suit from Clear H2O Tackle in Edwardsburg. I got these great snowmobile gloves, actually, from Chanel Marine. I got some old Mickey boots, long underwear. But I will tell you the real key, the real secret of staying warm when you're fishing in these types of conditions. Catch a fish, because that'll get your heart pumping like nothing else. Fish on?
Fish on.
Ned Rig again, Benelli.
Yeah,
it's a Ned.
Nothing right home about here. A little bit different, though.
This one of the bad characters is a little bit different. He was content with this. I don't know, man. I want to be here. Benelli got it. Oh, nice jump. Nice jump. Now the Ned Rig fish. Oh,
quick release.
Quick release. Now it's all about diversity. You watch my videos over the years, you know I'm a big believer in being diverse in your presentations. And the blade bait, generally speaking, is a deeper presentation. The Ned Rig can be a little bit of both. The Alabama Rig is mid-depth to deep, but you should always have a shallow water bait ready to go as well.
There we go. We're in a mouth, buddy.
And it's an undercrunch. That's an undercrunch bite. Yeah. Oh no! Ah, that was the best fish of the day. You tell you, I got this undercrunch. You talk about people know how to make swim baits or out in California by Pro Point lures here. It's an undercrunch. You can basically see exactly what it is. Swim bait with a little underspin under it. The weight's in here. I think this is honestly a fairly shallow presentation. Why would I be throwing that here in December at 40 degree water? Because sometimes fish will sneak up shallow. We're in these channels we talked about, and get to the end of this channel and it gets a little shallower with some weeds. That is a perfect place to throw this. A lot of people throw a rattle trap, and that can be good during the winter time. I don't believe it or not, 38 degree, 40 degree water rattle traps work, but something different is what I'm throwing is this undercrunch by Pro Point Lures. Again, everything I'm using today, we use, is in the description below. Yeah, that fish ripped off that eyeball. But this is a great presentation. And it's not to say you can't throw this deep. I think this is a 3/8 ounce model. Let it get down to 10, 12 feet. But generally speaking, when I see some shallow grass around some deep water, I'm definitely gonna throw this up there to try to catch myself what I would consider probably a big fish coming out of there. And I do believe the biggest fish we hooked today was with this undercrunch. One last vital piece of advice, information coming up right now that you can't miss out on if you want to save yourself a big headache. So many places this time of year, the boat docks are taken out of the water, which forces you to put your boat right up on that concrete. But you know what protects your fiberglass? It's a mega wear keel guard. There's even a promo code for it down below to save you a bunch of money.